Hi guys, it's Anais from Radio King and welcome to this video. Today we're going to look at how to easily create your very own radio website, and I'm going to show you all the essential features that are included in Radio King's offer. Let's dive right in. So before I show you all the cool things you can do with a radio website hosted by Radio King, let's quickly take a look at why having a website for your radio station is important. Having a website gives your listeners easy access to your radio station and content. If someone enters the name of your radio station in a search engine such as Google, you want your radio website to be the very first thing that pops up. Obviously, radio offers audio content only, but by creating a website, you can offer much more than that, such as blog articles or catch-up content, for example. Having a website is a great way to offer your listeners extra information about your radio station. If someone wants to take a look at past playlists or get a better idea of what your radio station is about, they can find that information on your website in a few easy clicks. With Radio King, you can easily create your very own radio website, customize it to your colors, and see the changes in real time. We have three different themes that are available to be customized to your liking and your radio station's branding. So let's take a tour of a demo radio website so you can look at all the available features. We'll then take a look at the admin panel so you can get a better idea of what goes on behind the scenes when you edit your website. So as I said, this is an example website, so it doesn't actually have any real content. I'm just using it in this video to show you all that you can do. I also want to mention that the website is 100% responsive, which means that it adapts to all screens. All the elements that you'll see on this demo website are 100% customizable, so you can change the colors, the layout, etc. So this website is made with our cupcake theme, and the particularity of this theme is that the menu is on the side rather than at the top. It also has a retractable player bar here at the bottom. This player bar will allow your listeners to continue listening to your radio station while they navigate through your website. So the homepage that we have here regroups all the available modules, but like I said, the layout is entirely customizable. We've got a big slider here that you can use to promote upcoming events or shows. You could also use it to promote your sponsors or even sell advertising space in this placement. Then, as you can see, we've got various modules highlighted directly on the homepage, so you can customize the layout according to different block sizes, but I'll show you a bit more in detail later on when we head over to the admin panel. And then right at the bottom, we've got all our links to social media pages and app downloads if you have an app, as well as the link to contact the radio station directly. So like I said, we've got a menu that appears on the side here, and that's divided into different categories to make navigating your website incredibly easy. So there's radio, music, media, participate, and contact. Let's take a quick look at each module. So the news module allows you to create your own news articles or integrate an RSS feed that automatically updates itself in real time, ensuring that your news is always up to date. So in the shows module, you can highlight all of your radio shows as well as their broadcasting schedule. You can add a description for each show and even include the DJs and podcasts as well if you provide catch-up content, for example. Then we have the team tab, which allows you to present all of your team members. So if we click on one, you can then add a description. If you have any upcoming events, you can list them here in the events module and people can search them by location or by date. In the music category, we've got top 10, which basically regroups all the tracks that people love on your radio station. So if you take a look at the player bar here, you'll notice that there's a little heart, and that allows your listeners to vote for the tracks that they like, and then the top 10 tracks will appear in this module here. In the artists module, you can list all of the artists that are broadcast on your radio station. And the played tracks module, as the name indicates, shows all the tracks that are played on your radio station. And what's great about this module is that people can actually search a specific day and time, and all the songs that were broadcast at that time will pop up. The playlist module, which is also called the music module, allows you to add all the music that was played on your radio station so that you can highlight them. Next, let's take a look at the photos module. So here, obviously, you can create separate albums and then upload pictures, for example, if you participate in a special event and things like that. It's a great way to add visual content to a medium like radio, like we said, which is generally just audio. Then we've got the podcast module. So again, you can create specific categories and then upload audio content as catch-up shows for people who weren't able to tune in live. You can add a picture, a description, and then all of the episodes will appear here at the bottom. And then we've got the videos module. So here you can easily add videos from YouTube or Dailymotion by simply entering the URL. Just like the other modules, you can create categories and subcategories to organize all of your content. If you want to add a video that isn't from YouTube or Dailymotion, you'll need to go through the pages module, which basically allows you to create a custom page from scratch. There you can integrate any video that you might have. Then in the last section, we've got the dedications module, and here your listeners can leave you little messages telling you how much they enjoyed your radio show, a particular song, or even just give a shout out to someone. And lastly, we've got the contests module, which will allow you to set up competitions and contests that people can participate in. And this is a really fun way to attract new listeners. So now that we've seen what your radio website could look like, let's take a look at the admin panel. So you'll arrive directly on your dashboard, which gives you a kind of overview of your visits. Under the statistics tab, you obviously get more detailed statistics about the visits on your website. So you've got page views, visits and users, and you can select a specific time period for that. And then you can also select what you want to see or not on the chart. Then you've got other tabs such as content, which gives you a specific idea of how many people have visited each page. Any referrers, the browsers that were used to access your radio website, the operating systems as well, and the geographic location of your visitors. Under the appearance tab, so like I said before, this is where you can modify the modules on your homepage. So as you can see, there are different size blocks. You can easily add a row and then directly select which module you want to integrate into that block. And then you can drag and drop it as well if you want to change the placement. When it comes to design, this is where you'll choose the theme of your website. So like I said, we're currently using the cupcake theme, which has the retractable player bar at the bottom. And then if we click on Edit Design Online, you'll have access to the editor, which will allow you to customize all of the elements on your website. So for example, if I click on the player bar, then we can change the appearance, you can change the color. You can choose whether the cover displays on the player or not. The different formats of the covers, whether it's square, rounded, just a bunch of different customizable options. And you'll have that choice for each different module, each different section of your website. And like I said, this theme is responsive, so you can also take a look at what it would look like on a tablet or on a mobile device. Then you've got the menu configuration here as well, where you can organize the categories of your menu, the sidebar as well. So this is what appears here on the side of each page. So you can modify all the blocks that appear here. And then you've got your SEO configuration as well, where you can enter the title that you want, any keywords, a meta description, and that's just going to help your website be visible on search engines. Your modules are then divided into different tabs, so content, animation, interaction, and audio. And these tabs allow you to configure all of the content in each of the modules that appear on your website. Each module configuration is pretty much the same. So for example, if we go to the news tab, you'll have news management where you can add news. You'll have the categories. So like I said, you can create different categories and then subcategories to organize your content. You'll have SEO configuration again with keywords and meta description. And then you'll have the general settings of that module. So you can choose how many items are displayed per page, the order in which they appear, if you want the publication date, if you want to activate comments, sharing, etc. So like I said, that's pretty much the same for each module. So same with the videos, We've got the video management, categories, SEO, and then settings. And if we head over to audio, then same thing for your music. You've got music management, categories, SEO configuration. So like I said, pretty much the same configuration for each module, which makes your life much easier. Then let's head over to the general parameters of your website. So under configuration, this is where you'll give your website a title, if you want to give any tags, the meta description, and then any personalized JavaScript code. You can add your favicon, which is the little icon that appears here at the top. And then you can choose the language of your website and the time zone as well. You can then configure other options such as external APIs, your social networks as well, so that will appear in the footer and right at the top of your website. You can activate a chat, the email as well, for people to be able to contact you directly, and then there are privacy options as well, so the cookie consent form, for example. Then you've got your player configuration as well, so you can easily just add a radio station. So choose the name. If you have a radio station with Radio King, then you'll be able to select it from the list here. Choose the type. So even if you don't have a radio station hosted with Radio King, you can still configure your radio station, no problem. And then we've got the users module as well, which will allow you to add your team members so that they can also help you out with your website. And then you've got the roles management section as well, depending on the access that you want to grant to each person. And lastly, there's the ads module, which will allow you to add advertisement to your website as well. So as you can see, there are different formats, squares and banners. You can see how many people clicked on those. So you can give your advertisers the statistics that come from your radio website. And there you have it. You now know how to create a responsive website for your radio station, complete with numerous modules and SEO optimization. So obviously I didn't go into too much detail for each of the modules, so please feel free to launch your very own free 7-day trial to dig a little deeper and play around with the many options. Head over to radioking.com under products website, or simply click on the link in the description below. Thanks for watching.